know, like, it's nice to see in-game stuff, but it's also nice to see outside games.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
Just like, you just started kind of, like, you know, after that, like, I found Snowball, like, I saw a couple of people who were working on the simple stuff as well.
Yeah.
Did you deserve to be on this panel? Come on.
Thank you.
We've
done
those panels.
Yeah,
well.
So we've been those.
Yeah.
it's been really good to see more people actually doing farm as possibly.
Yeah.
I think there was maybe 5 people last year, including us.
Yeah.
A lot more this year.
We're going to go over a few things. So we just want to talk about why we started the community. So like when Ben and I started the community, we were actually approached by Square Enix because me and Ben were active on social media. We just do stuff together. And we used to just talk about Final Fantasy. And the idea was that there was no active members in Australia that we could find. Like, I mean, 4 or 5 years ago when Realm of Dawn started, like, did you know, like, it was hard to find players in Australia. We needed to go to Tom Perry. Now now with that, with the page has grown to 2,000 members, which we've just recently hit. So we're very now it's the actual statistics of the page, which is actually amazing. And Ben's put all these together for me, and he says he loves you all too, by the way. On the average Facebook page, you can have up to 5 million people for certain games, certain titles, and that's in a region globally. This one is just in Australia. Those pages on average have 2% of activity. This page has 90% of activity daily from members. So that's just people that like the page. So you've all been on the Final Fantasy page every day. So I know my phone goes listening. I can mute it sometimes because you love that game.
I've actually just given up.
Yeah, just drain the battery. The community is very diverse. 50% males, 50% females, and I'm not actually making that up. That's true. It's good to see, like, for all walks of life, everybody's come together on this page. Like, for those that haven't been on there, there's no arguments, there's no fights, there's no name calling or bullying, which there's zero tolerance for that. Sorry, I apologize. There's zero tolerance for that, and that's just amazing. And power of Final Fantasy, no matter what title you love, this is ours, is 14, it's just incredible. And you don't really see that on other Facebook pages. Like, who's been on Facebook and just seen bullying, name calling? Like, can I give a show of hands? It can be pretty toxic out there, but this Facebook page is just brilliant, it's lovely, and it's Final Fantasy. Like, yeah, I'm very passionate about Final Fantasy myself. So, I'm gonna talk a little bit, we're gonna start with Brad. So, who watches Twitch here? Like, is there any Twitch fans out here? Like, anyone watches Twitch on Final Fantasy on Twitch? So, Brad, I'll let you take away with what are the joys and benefits you have of streaming on Twitch?
Yeah, sure. So, I've been streaming on Twitch more or less full time for approximately 2 years, and I did a year before that. Before that, I did television, like, and stage presentation, all that kind of stuff. The thing I like about Twitch as compared to where I used to work in, like, the television media space is I do get to interact with people in real time, and it's really cool for games like Apple, which is why I just stream as much as I do. It's because it's so easy to have, like, really fun free company conversations, or like pubs, or like people on the chat. Because there's a server I play on Fanfare at the moment, we're going to be changing profile over to Kajala pretty soon.
In all from Kajala?
Kajala?
Yeah. 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 Yeah, right there.
I've also got a character on Tombury as well. Any Tombury people?
By the way, your character's still in my FC.
Yeah. That is true.
So we keep him as a trophy.
Pretty much. Because I love my favorite character all the time.
Yeah, he's my favorite character. We kind of keep him at the bottom of our list because you haven't copied him, so.
Nah, it's all good. But like, something that I enjoy doing is having those conversations, especially with people like community members. Like, you know, it's like, I want help with this. Cool, just pop on the screen and we'll come give you a hand. And it's a really cool way to engage with the community from a ground level because it's like a direct person playing the game. You can just join and interact with them immediately. And from my point of view, it's really cool. Because I get to interact with all of you guys directly. So you'll see whenever I'm streaming it, I just post in the Facebook group. I'm streaming, I'm on this server today, because I have a few different characters at different levels on different servers, just so people from kind of all walks of life in the group can engage. I find that really, really fun to do. It's been a really rocking year, especially since I did so much with this, because I recently went to Japan. And I did some stuff with Square Enix there as well, such as the Final Fantasy 14 AOC Cafe. And we'll talk about this later on, and the Aeoxian Orchestra Symphony as well, which Square Enix got me involved to look at because of the stream
service. Okay, so is anyone out here that streams on Twitch? Do you have any Twitch
Anyone considered considered streaming on Twitch?
Anyone considered streaming on Twitch?
Start. It's the golden
just
one.
Just start.
Download a program and just start. It's really that simple to get going. Once you start, then you can be like, now what? And it's really cool because you know you guys can do it if you're a free company.
Just make sure you're not on dial-up.
Pardon?
Just make sure you're not on dial-up.
I got partnered on ADSL1, thank you very much. So that is not an excuse.
We recently just upgraded from satellite.
But like, you can start, and just keep it simple if you want. Just like maybe, you know, I'll just show my free company to begin with. You can do Discord video calls now. Maybe just do a Discord video call with it. You can start from there. That's totally fine.
I'm still waiting for a crafting stream.
Hey,
you can do that.
Gonna fish for 20 hours, let's go.
I'm going
to get like a, you can bring it up and get like one of those Dreamcast machine controllers.
Oh, alright.
Yeah, definitely start. Any questions about that? So I'm at the booth all weekend. There's actually three Twitch partners at the booth. There's myself. Is Ethis the other host? And Heal Me Harry, who's helping out as well. So we're all Twitch partners, we all play people seriously. Those two especially, so feel free to just come heckle us, hassle us, ask any questions. We are here to help. The more people stream the game, the faster the community grows.
Yeah, that's it. And that actually spreads the word for the Australian and New Zealand community. So if you think about having a go, give it a go. There's definitely a lot of people out there. If you watch Twitch, definitely consider watching on Facebook thing. Okay, Michael, we're going to talk about our first ever meetup. So,
oh, yes.
Can I just show hands? And I'm like, if you put your hand up, I know you're lying, because I know everyone that was there. our first meetup was at a place called the Nerd Cave in Sydney. Has anyone ever heard of the Nerd Cave?
It's a pretty good place.
Yeah, it was well played, actually.
Yeah.
So, we did our very first meetup at the Nerd Cave. It was a small gathering. We had, I believe, 10 monitors set up.
Yeah,
that's where I first met Michael, because we came in. And that was the first moment, like, wow, like, people were lining up at the door to come in, like, well, this is what I got, like, the people are here. And from that, we had it was a room of about 30 people, I believe.
It was about 30.
I had a photo I would show, it was about 30 people all sitting on the steps, it's kind of like a, you know, just first school photo.
I think it was like our first color photo.
The first color photo.
I actually got a funny story about that meetup. Before I knew about the page, playing a game with a group of friends I met from uni. Funny thing, I got back into FF14, I brought my PS4 into uni. I know it's kind of productive, but I wanted to play something.
Classic game.
But I brought it in, and my friend, you might know him, he's very active on Donberry, Lunar Horizon. Anyone? Yeah, a couple people, yeah. And he's my best friend. And so he saw FF14 on my PS4, and he said, "Wait, you play FF14? I'm like, "Not really, not anymore." He's like, "Dude, resub. I want to get you into the game." And like after that, he got me all the way from Real Reborn all the way through Heaven's Ward.
Wow,
straight away. Like we didn't stop. We went for it. And Heaven's Ward just came out at the time, so a lot of the new things he didn't know, I didn't know. We're just laughing. I still remember the moment I found out about every warrior had that moment of like, what is this skill? 500 potency? Have they gone bad? We were just having so much fun, and then we made NFC, and I was a bunch of friends from uni and all that kind of stuff. And I was looking through Facebook, like just randomly looking through Facebook, and I see an event, just random event, FF14 ANZ at New Game. And it was like, God, it was on a day that we were all free. It was in a place that we could all go to. And I went to like a Discord call of everyone. And I said, "Yo, let's crash this party." So it was an FC, let's crash this party. Like, let's just have like only about 20 people going. Yeah, we've got like 10. Let's crash this party. And yeah, we just all came as a group. And there was this few setups there. It was people playing like, they were playing like a little, like doing Gridania. And I'm like, let's do Nick Stream. We're just like, oh, let's do it, and then we're playing it, and a lot of people are curious, like, whoa, what is this, you know? And it's the same feeling I had at the booth,
right?
A lot of people asking, like, whoa, what is this vibe, what is all that? So, you know, at the Nerd Game event, it was just yeah, we're just playing mid-extreme and just having fun. We're wiping, not to like, everyone knows like Fame Core at the time, but mid-extreme just came out around the time. So like everyone was like kind of trying to figure it out. And when Fame Core happened, we were all like, whoa, we haven't seen this. And like, you know, we're just having so much fun.
That's always really fun.
Yeah.
I think when you guys
had
dwarves, was
mine
on the next one?
Want to go? That's what I was going to go on today.
Yeah.
So, yeah. We went to PAX last year. Alright. Lodges. Then we moved into our next event, which was a pre-PAX Final Fantasy Party. Now, we completely booked that place out, thanks to a company called Survivor, that's an online review site based here in Australia. We were able to hold pretty awesome event. Is anyone here that was there last year?
Yeah.
So this just shows how big the community's growing, because this, if you were here last year, you would have been blown away by this party. We had a limited edition PS4, Heavensward, PS4's to give away, thanks to Survivor. Now, I've actually personally got a very good story for this. So Ben and I took my hat off, we put a bunch of names in there for everyone was at the door. And I said to everyone, if you don't put your hand up quick enough and don't yell at your name, I'm going to eat your ticket. Chance. So, now, there was a young gentleman by the name of Josh Davidson, and he's deaf, and I pulled his name out, and I've called it out, didn't answer, and I put the ticket in my mouth, and then out of nowhere, Steve, from Survivor, was manning the door that night, and then he went, wait a minute, reached his hand down my throat, pulled it out, and Josh Davidson, he's like, going through. And because Josh has a notepad so he can write down to communicate with you. And he won. And you cannot stage that sort of thing. So that, and the articles that were about that, it kind of got a bit more traction the community known. And like that was just one of the amazing events we've done. And it has been across,
I'm going to interrupt you first. I met him at the booth just like an hour ago.
Yeah.
And he was like, he was playing. And Ben pretty much came up to me and like I was like, okay, and he just tapped on my shoulder and was like, that's not this from PAX. And I'm like, I couldn't, because I didn't go to PAX, unfortunately. I was studying at the time, and I just didn't have enough time to come out now. And he's like, I'm like, who are you talking about? He's like, oh, he's the guy who won the PS4. I'm like, oh, he's like, and he's like, he's deaf as well. And I'm like, whoa, wow, okay. And I was just like, oh, I just pop, like, just behind him, you know, like, usually I do, like, when I'm at the booth, like, experience, and you know, it was writing on the notepad, and it was like, and he was just like writing like, bard? Question mark? Archer? Question mark? And I'm like, I got this, and I bought bard, and I pretty much just like, because he had the card with him, you know, we have a card at the booth that tells you like pretty much a basic,
description,
description, rotation, that kind of stuff, like, and like, he was smiling the whole time, like, I could see him, he loved it, he loves his game.
Afterwards with
his
shirt and his
tattoos. Yeah, it was a yeah, really nice guy. So he definitely deserved that piece, for sure.
Yeah, I remember last year when he won it, he was just so happy. It was like the best moment of the entire.
It was so cool.
He had the PS4 in his hand and he's like waving it around. Yeah.
Don't do that!
He was so happy.
Hasn't got one. But,
like,
there's been major events in mine on this. Like the Nerd Cables one. The major almost won before. There's other people in Melbourne doing it now, but I used to run Twitch meetups here. And the first Twitch meetup we did was actually combined with Final Fantasy 14, which was just before the PAX one actually. And that was really cool. We had a bunch of like Christmas rules, prizes in a way that Square Enix and PAX would be very happy to supply for us. And there's so many things that you guys are interested in. You have communities. This is stuff that you guys can do. All I did was like, here's my event, I'm running here, this many people, what can you do for me? Thankfully, I happened to run it. It was after the PAX party, sorry. Because it was run at their sister venue, and they still had all the banners. So, cool, my name got 20 banners for nothing. Easy. But that's something you guys can do, and don't hesitate to give a crack at it.
Yeah, we've seen a lot of community members just say, hey, does anyone want to get a drink? Or anything like that. I think New Zealand had an event as well.
They did.
It was run by a great guy, Justin Green. Gax, if everyone knows, from Tonberry.
Yeah,
Gax. I can't get rid of him. He's just there. New Zealand meetups. Everyone heard Pandy or Hallie. You know, like you guys can just make events and just talk to an admin on the page, and we'll promote it.
Yeah.
You know, we want people to get together and talk about this game.
It's got a really good opportunity.
It's nice, you know, it's nice to like, you know, isn't it nice to sit next to someone and talk about just like, you know, oh, I ran that dungeon, or I ran this content, and how are you feeling about all this, you know? And, you know, it's, I want everyone to just get together and just love this game so much. And, yeah, I just, more best, guys, come on, more
best. You want to see more of Final Fantasy 14, guys?
Yeah!
We need people to see, let them know. Who wants to see
Final Fantasy 14? By the way, people at the booth, don't be
they're listening, believe me.
They're listening, trust me, they're listening. Yeah, people at the booth, super nice. Like, please don't be afraid, you know. Honestly, when I started talking, I was scared, you know. Oh my god, these people from Square Enix. And, like, the first thing they said to me is, hey, what people do? We love this game. Just, you know, like, ah, we've got questions to ask them, you know, and, yeah, it's really good.
So, we're going to jump forward to Stormblood now. So, who's anyone here from Sydney?
Yep.
So, did anyone go to the Stormblood launch party? Yeah, that was a really cool event. So I believe we were GameSpot. We had it at Sydney at the Oxford Art Factory. I believe I was right there, Oxford Art Factory. And we, sorry, I've been talking all pack. So
join the club, man.
We got a Skype video. Yoshi P, and he answered all our questions. Now, that was actually really cool. Like, they're listening. It just shows that they're listening. So he answered our questions one-on-one, pretty much Skype straight back to us. That was a video. And that just proves that what we're doing here is listening. So if you have questions, ask them to the page, to the admins, and they're actually making their way to Square Enix. Now, That was a very successful party. I sadly couldn't be there. Michael, you were there. Do you want to talk a little bit about how the party ran?
Yeah, sure. Also, moving off that question, if you guys got feedback, tell me. Like, I'll listen and I'll pass it along, like, as best I can.
Well, speaking of, do you have any good
working
questions?
Working on it, I kid you not, I'm working on it so hard. Like, trust me, future events, merch is going to be there. It's just, this event was just really put together, really quick.
Doing the best we can.
Really happy about it.
Merch is always really cool, but also always a bit tricky to do.
Australian
fanfare.
I
wish.
One step
at a time. I'm on
that
morning.
Italian servants.
Yeah. Okay. Let's try not to get into that topic.
It's a dangerous spiral we're going
in. Actually, run out of time. You want to talk about as much as we can about this movie. We'll talk about that topic. That's feedback I want.
That's good because you put up with the trial disc here.
Wow. Okay. That's really good. Yeah.
Good brainstorm.
Hey, any ideas like that, come see me, message me.
Watch post to the Facebook
group. You know, like this, and Square Enix is watching, like they're looking at the page. So trying to refrain from doing something a little bit stupid on it. You know, I've had Mac a lot of stuff. I've done some really questionable things. So actually, when I got the memo that Square Enix were looking at the page, I kind of was like, oh no.
That moment of dread, right?
I don't think I said something stupid at any point. No, I think I'm okay. And it's just, but yeah, talking about the Stormblood VIP event, it was a private event. GameSpot were running it. You had to get invitations and you had to enter a competition. And it was a really nice venue, actually. It was pretty small, but the space that the team worked on it was really good. Like they had a giant like Xeno sort of like yeah, just big.
The
Just the wall displays, and like a very like a Kugane, like quite an inspired like just arch just at the doorway. It was just really nice.
If you guys haven't seen it, there should be photos of that in the Facebook.
Yeah, there was plenty of them. And a lot of it was a big turnout. A lot of people came, I remember because it was a couple of days after early access. So we were all kind of just like, what were you doing? You know, what were you doing? And like pretty much like 50% was like, oh, robotic stream. I just couldn't get past them. Like, people were like, oh yeah, I got through with a macro. I was like, yeah, I'm a macro. Just moments like that, and you know, it's stories that we're just like sharing each other. And we, when we did get through, we were just talking about like, because you can see the skills before you get done. So we're like, oh, but what is this skill? And it was a really fun event just because the community was there, and like, and we were just like talking, drinking. Yeah, and also Effie's was there. I have a lot of stories, and you know, I've been with Steve for so long, and they're all great. I actually didn't know Effie's was Australian until that very day, because I almost had a heart attack seeing him. Because like I was just like, I always assumed it was American because he's hanging out with Mr. Happy, and like Mary and all that stuff. And when I saw him just standing there casually talking to Ben, I'm like,
did they fly me?
Yeah. And he's like, oh, I need to talk to him right now. But I'm a big fan of, I love his little videos, all that kind of stuff. Like, who here watches his little videos?
Yeah. Sure, he has some amazing content. He just hit the on the booth. So I'm talking 3 days.
So sure, he's a very nice guy. So if you have any questions, just ask him. And he, we start talking and all that kind of stuff. And he was doing the stream with,
Yeah, it was big,
and like, they were doing that at the same time, and it was funny because like, they were in early access, and they were in the queue. Because everyone remembers the queue, right?
Yeah.
Trying to get into that game, and they were just like struggling to get in, and I was just like, no. And no, the event was successful. It was fantastic.
The highlight for me was the group
everyone was just doing the like that was a really good one.
So we'll jump forward to what is now PAX 2017. This is the very first year Stormblood has made a presence on its own, like outside of Square Enix to Australia. Now, do you enjoy how the booth looks? Does it look good?
Yeah.
You notice it's like one of the only titles on that floor that's not with a big developer, like big publisher. So you've got Ubisoft and all that, and there's Stormblood, one title on its own, which is pretty amazing. And when I was walking through watching them set it up, and they go, we're looking at all the other developers, and go, yeah, this is our basic setup. We thought we may have went overboard, so...
It just shows that booth's their base package.
That's it, base package.
Base package. And I was like, I love this booth so much. And like, base package.
And obviously, for those that are doing it right there, for yesterday and today, I think every five person I've seen someone wear a shirt. We're seeing a lot of shirts here right now.
Awesome.
So, in with these events, because we'll talk a bit more about the game, because the game's pretty cool.
I want to stop you for a bit. I really want to mention this.
Yeah.
How important this is. Who came in yesterday and called actually?
How many is?
You all enjoying your shirts?
What are you?
Because 100% clear, right?
That is
officially in Square Enix a world record. Hands down, we are the only like booth to have ever done 100% of
action. Actually, I'm going to cut you off there. That's true. That's not true. We actually do have some shirts. So give away. We saved some for you. So
We've got a little goodie bag here.
As far as I'm aware, it's not just 100% for last year, it's just the first time. And they've been doing these booths for a long time.
Yeah.
As far as I'm aware, that's the first time, like, flat out, period, that every booth is
100%. And.
Yeah, there was that one.
You guys want to hear an amazing story about yesterday? Because a lot of you might have, like, went home already. That's fair enough. But, we were like, we're so close. We're so close to 100%. Keep it up, guys. And then Dean, the lovely Dean, who was our queue master, like years, he's a real life duty finder. lovely guy. You should tell this. If you see the man with, like, having is Leo Fire on Tom Berry. So, you know, hey, don't tell him I said this, but go join his FC, Glitterbomb.
Yeah.
He wants people. He's
hungry.
He's hungry. Yeah, he's just warm and cuddly. But the amazing story was, like, we had like 50 minutes left, you know, really close to the end. And Dean comes up to me personally. I was like, what's up, Dean? And he's like, oh, get new group rating. He's like, we've got 7 people who have not touched the game before.
Quite specifically, the main table.
White face. Dean, you're kidding, right? And he's like, no, 7 people. Well, who's the experienced person? Dean.
Six new players and one that hadn't played since like an hour.
Yeah.
Basically, new players.
And Yoshi FX was like on the commentary. You saw the fight.
That was intense.
It was like,
who was here who actually watched that?
You actually watched that.
Because they're both Edison and Carson and Matthew.
You all know them.
Well, right? I'm not right.
You all that, you know, I'm going to lead up to it. But pretty much six, like 7 people, you know. If you were there, you would have noticed that we took a little bit longer to prepare them than everyone else. It was supposed to be like 5 minutes per group, but we were like taking like 15 minutes or something. Because we really wanted to make sure that they were okay. And we split into groups. I was teaching 4 new people, like 4 people, not touching the game. Pretty much bam, 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 teaching them everything, mechanics, how to play their classes. I actually kind of freaked out a bit because I don't play Machinist. I haven't played Machinist since I was 12. So if you're a Machinist main, you would know my confusion at the new abilities and the new mechanics. I was like, oh no, no, no. So he basically had the card. So I was like, just give me a second. Okay, I get it. So I was just teaching. I was like, okay, we're learning together. And I told him and like pretty much gave him the basic idea of heated and hot shot and making sure to refresh it every time. And wildfire, and like, is it wildfire? It's wildfire, right? And then I pretty much okay, you're done. You're the next person. And then we were like, well, it's ready as the game would be. So, start. I'm just stressing. And the Square Enix reps are behind me. And because the main rule is I'm not allowed to touch the keyboard once they start. I'm not allowed to touch the keyboard. Only exception is when they don't target the enemy. Because a lot of new players don't know that you push tab to really just tap. And or move their camera because people were looking at the floor. They're not going to see anything. And or they zoom too close and like, oh, I want to see my character. They're really pretty. Because they're like, no, you need to see the button because the mechanics. Scroll out of it. And they went in and it was shaky. It was so shaky. You had Hilmi Harry, who was pretty much on the microphone, calling out when to dodge, you know, that kind of stuff. And I had Dean pretty much on the two healers. And I was like looking at it. And the fight got pretty good, it was okay. They were doing pretty good, tanking, but it was like, thankfully. And we got up to, pretty much just it was shaky, but we got to like the sword, you know, I ran to the tank and said click orbs and like pretty much got through pretty good, you know, it was okay. And then the deaths started happening. one by one. And it was just the two healers left. And one tank. Everyone was clenching so hard. And the thing is, I was on the other side with the DPSs. And I'm looking over, and I see Dean with the two healers. And
There was a white mage and a skull.
And Dean, I love him. I really do. But he doesn't really have great experience. He's a nice guy. He just does the fun things, you know. He likes scavenging. But he never really had like great experience. He was never really good at, like, he's not really good. He has raided, like, back in Realm Reborn, he did coils, but it's so long between them now, he's just a lovable goof now. But he really doesn't know to, like, he really struggled struggled, that's the word, struggled, because I saw his hand, like struggling to direct the healers. I'm like, no, I'm not going to let this. I'm not going to let 100% end on this party that just came out of nowhere. So I sprinted to the healers, and I feel really bad. And he said sorry to me 7 times. Dude, Dr. DPS, I'm going to teach the healers right now. And pretty much, the moment we switched, the white mage
died. Switch out to the experienced paladin
and the
panicking skull.
His hands were shaking. And we were so close to the referee. I don't understand. We're so close. And thankfully, the tank won the legend. I shook his hand. I was too drained afterwards, but I really hope I did shake his hand. Scholar was like, just pretty much, yeah, well, so I mean, Scholar had an enabling marker on it, and Limit Break just popped. And I told him, like, I was like, Limit Break. I was pointing to on his screen, Limit Break. And his hot bar wasn't locked. Dragged it off his hot bar. Oh no, so close. He had it and he held onto it and I'm like, no, stop. And then it got worse. He clicked on it and then he started moving. And like, thankfully that anyway takes so long. And it's like, just click on it. And I'm like, stop. And then you saw the moment. Pulse of life, everyone comes up. And from then on,
crowd was up.
Oh my god, it was
really.
And then I directed the white mage, and yeah, because I know white mage very well. I main heal my white mage, and we just normally wiped after that.
This is also really close to the end of the fight as well. Because obviously,
yeah, it was
like
really close.
It was like last 10%. So
really,
like down.
It was 54. It was really quite big because everyone started wiping once.
Oh, that's right.
And because we're so excited. Yeah. My skull raised that you kind of just like lost track.
Pretty much, yeah.
And then after that, like, yeah, it was smooth sailing. And they cleared it, and they cleared it. I was happy. Well, I was helping the healer. So, I was pretty much saying, like, medical one, medical two. Getting a size, you know, and like making sure, like, because he was really shaking. Like, just having two healers that have never healed before. Scary. But yeah, I think that's probably the biggest. Like, I was
the moment of the show.
Moment of the show. Also, shout outs to Team FC Court for getting. Yeah, yeah, yeah. They got the fastest clearance.
Three healer positions. Shout-outs to Stoneforl.
Stoneforl. You know what? I actually want more people to do that.
Well, our fastest Susanoo clear was also a free heal composition.
How about next event? How about we have like a race for people? Huh? Secret prizes. Yeah. Get your groups together and maybe try to aim for the fastest clear. Yeah.
We'll speed up because we're involved. Like, Mike's doing great for the first time he's back. He's very down to perform, but yeah, he's doing really good. Yeah. So,
I'd be lying if I said I wasn't scared right now.
So, I'll just go over quickly. There's also who had some dominoes recently. enjoyed that. And also, who's a fan of like Hannity? Like, you've seen their show. They're obviously, we partnered with Hannity. So, and it just shows that there's a voice on stroke. So, we thank you and we want you to loud and just scream out. Have fun. So, we actually got some. We do have some shows left. So, we want to actually take the time to talk to you. So, if you have any questions, please queue here or here.
We have Mike on both sides.
So, if there's anything you want to talk, you're ready to get up. You can see your screen. Yeah.
Go for it. Sweet.
Almost a month now, going to start doing Samurai. I was wondering, the game really pulled me to it with its aesthetic and its music, and then after that I started seeing, well, its mechanics really neat. What's the main draw that 14 has over all the other MMOs on the market right now for you?
Oh, I can answer that really easily. I like a lot of abilities. I like having options. Comparing other MMOs, the only other MMO I really touched was Guild Wars 2. And that was, but that was during launch.
That was launch.
I was so excited. It was the same group of friends again. They were like trying to get me into Guild Wars 2, and it's not for me. And I'll explain why. When I got to the first sort of area, I learned all my abilities in like 20 minutes. I felt like, oh, this is it. Like, I'm sure, I think they've changed it now. And you start learning.
Back then, it was really basic.
Yeah, back then, you could learn everything. You can just learn everything straight away, and you can switch to different things.
Yeah.
At least that's how I remember it.
But this one was very
small.
For FF14, when I got into it, I liked, and obviously I love Final Fantasy. I played it like pretty much all of them. But I just liked having new abilities and knowing how they chain off each other. And you can go online, you can see rotations, all that kind of stuff, But a funny thing about Monk, actually, that always gets my friends, and they get annoyed with me every time I do it, is I try to incorporate Tornado Kick in. And they're like, what are you doing, Koi? What are you doing? I'm like, I'm doing more damage.
The numbers.
I like having big numbers. And they're like, obviously I just do it for fun. Because the argument is, my response to them is like, why are you using that? It's so useless. Like, you don't want to lose your Priest Lightning. But at any point, I'm like, but why did they change it so it's less cooldown? Obviously, they want me to use it more. It used to be a lot longer. And then they shortened it to like 30 seconds or something. So I'm like, oh, I'm going to spam this, whatever. Now, obviously, it's not optimal, but, I have fun with it. And you can find your own way of playing this game. Don't worry about just the end game rating, rotation, stuff like that. Find a way that you play that make you feel comfortable. Actually, good story.
Actually, Mike on mine has to tell you.
Yeah, that's fine. Sorry, I have a lot of stories. I'm sorry. Go. That's it.
Thank you.
So we'll go left.
So I have a lot of abilities. I have fun. So that's good.
Nice. My question is, what classes are you looking forward to if they do release another class from all the Final Fantasy?
Like, what class would you like to see?
Yes.
Blue Mage.
Yeah!
Solo class.
Huh?
Yoshida said
if
we
were gonna do Blue Mage,
he'd
likely do a solo class.
Oh.
I mean, I
want to
see
Gear
Master.
Yeah. That's White Mage.
Beast Master.
Yes.
Yes.
Another pet.
Yeah, the dancer.
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 Oh God, dancer. You know what?
Do you know the April Fool's joke they did? The exercise video one?
No.
No one? I guess
the fighting game was.
Pardon?
The fighting game.
No. It was they released that was an 11.
Actually.
I've been playing it for a while.
I'll do a quick one. You guys will watch the Stormblood, not the launch, but the opening that they gave before the official Fanfest one?
I was there.
How many of you actually wanted Cannon Cleaner? I wanted a cannon cleaner. When they saw that guy clean the cannon, I wanted that as like a cycle of the hand.
Maintenance worker.
For serious talk, I'd like a Beastmaster. I'd like another pet. Pet class, maybe.
A real pet class.
Oh, yeah. Wow. Don't you like seeing Big Bahamut on the screen, everywhere? So good.
Do you ever think there's going to be a better crafting inventory?
Always like to see improvements to the game.
Thanks.
You guys don't understand how much of a server toll it had. I'm just getting you guys more inventory space. I was talking to I don't want to talk about it. I feel like I'm going to talk a little bit harder. I think what we've got now is really good. jettison PS3. Rest in peace, I did try it on that.
I played on PS3.
Face for forever.
Shut up, you started on PS3.
I did.
Why don't you have it on PS3?
Right.
They recently released that soundtrack, by the way, the one that has all the final tracks on.
Oh god! Oh,
please, man. Google. I'm not watching these videos. Me and my friend are watching
it. Nidhogg. That combination of the entire storyline into that one fight.
Good question.
When that thing dropped, oh my god. Oh, so good, Alright, next question.
I recently changed from Paladin to Ninja and found myself with abilities all over my hotbar. What are like the best tips for like organizing your hotbar?
You're asking a person who's been on the booth for like 2 days.
I have more hot bars.
Before I came to PAX, I actually had it in my head. I didn't know it was going to be a default hot bar there. I wanted to have like just your active abilities, your like defensive or offensive abilities on your second hot bar, and your job stuff on your third hot bar. And try to sort it in a way that's not like you can really like just get to it.
Everyone's hot bars have been really different up until the moment, because I can see all the feeds. Everyone's seeing some really interesting, really different hot bars.
I usually do the three hot bars, and then like that's enough. Sort of. Make it people understand. Just you've got pretty much active cooldowns or buffs and then jobs, job specific stuff.
So, thank you for your question.
Thank you so much.
What's your most memorable moment, like in game playing? We had one with Red Scout. Someone off through A3 Raid Wipe.
Oh,
that's going to be up there soon. Anything like that for you guys?
Yep, I got one. I'll do it as quick as I can. It's when I found out Felt Leaf. Okay, then I thought you could pull with that. My friend Luna, my best friend Luna at the time, he's still now, but was healing, right? And I did a Felt Leaf. I wasn't just going, like, dude, I think I can pull this, man. Look at this Felt Leaf pull. Hit the bell clip, went straight to game join. I guess that's not how you're supposed to use it. Doesn't get enmity, dude. He's like yelling at me, like, oh, that's a little cool.
as long as we don't pull with provoke.
Hey, it's better than bell clip, trust me. Provoke, to be honest. Thank you, great question.
Alright.
This is actually a community sub, because you've been name dropping Tomberry an awful lot. And as we know, the pool is closed, people. In lieu of an Australian server, do we have plans to dedicate an Australian-dominated server?
We have a few, depending on. So Tomberry's obviously the major one. Kajada's kind of the second one.
Kajada's the secondary one.
If you're using US servers, it used to be the headless.
I don't know much about the NA stuff.
It's Adamantos now.
There's some Australians. If you're a legacy player.
To answer your question, Kajada is secondary. I really don't have a clear answer for you. Like right now, when Tomberry, funny thing, Tomberry closed when we were at the VIP event, by the way. I was like, oh, really? I saw the notes. Like, oh, no. But to really answer your question, how many of you would actually transfer to an Australian server? Not that good, trust me.
For the time being, in terms of time, Kajana's kind of on the
board. Kajana's the secondary, and
Tomberry.
Tomberry was the main one, but in case Kajana does close, we'd have to sort it out as it's happening. So it's a very it's very organic. Like the fan page itself is very organic. I mean, so like we have to just go with the flow.
Post in the group.
Until there's a solid solution, I cannot give you an answer.
Thank you so much.
We got 10 minutes. I was playing on Friday in the booth, and Passerby accused me of being a bot. So
So I gave him 20,000 gil. I was wondering what server the bot, the Pax is playing.
We're not announcing which server it's on at the moment, just to keep things simple.
Okay, okay. The reason why I don't really push that, some people figured it out, you know? kudos to them. Kudos to them. They were, like, the moment I saw someone doing friend search, I know what you're trying to do. Like, come on, man. And there's already people there already talking to the passenger. I had to hop on and say, hey, Koi Senpai here, please, just, there's kids around, they might read the chat, please act nice. I love you all. Like, I did, I wrote that. And, like, people were like, with their hands and stuff, but,
Yeah, we're getting really tight. A question that will make you all be judged by the community. Which one is your favorite free company leader and why is it Admiral?
No comment.
Excuse me. I'm my own free company.
I'm his free company.
Obviously, I am great. As long as it's not Giraz, who's on Hailstorm,
just in time for
Alright, last show. So this answer a really good question then. What's your favorite fight in the game?
Fight?
Let's get Getsu.
Mine's probably Ravana.
Ravana?
Yeah.
That fight shift. Holy.
What has happened to you? I can relate.
I'll name drop one. Bahamut.
Yep.
Good question. The new one?
Yes.
Yeah, new. No,
I'm gonna have a whole week off of that.
Sort of the same question, but from a social aspect, what's the best sort of raid or dungeon to do with friends?
Call me crazy.
What?
49.
All right, Lost City.
100%.
No. Granted, it is the longest. It feels like the longest, and you'll be on Discord with them a lot. You gotta talk about something in there.
That's a good
answer.
Good question.
What do you think the next big bad will be after the Empire?
Oh.
So what would be the next big bad?
Unfortunately, Effie's is not here. We don't have our resident lore master here. But big bad after.
Elidibus.
I wonder, can I keep in mind there might be people here who are not at endgame yet?
Let's
try to avoid story questions.
For the big bad next, I really don't know. Next question.
I just started playing 2 weeks ago. And I've got 5 other friends joining me soon, so I was just wondering, they have never played MMOs before, I'm the only one who has done it. What is a good, easy newcomer raid when we get up there?
If you're starting up the game, don't worry about raids anytime soon. They're very much, it's not like,
it'll be a while.
Yeah, it's a while off. It's something for what you do. Honestly, when you're starting off a game, you'd want to, first of all, join together, get each other on a friends list, you know, make a live show, talk each other in game,
join a Facebook group.
Ben just added me on the Facebook.
Oh, I've actually read about
19
people
in
the last day.
Oh, my God. I actually heard you. Quick story. Yeah. When we first started the page, there was actually a race to see who could actually add people to the page. We got Ben, which is like a machine gun.
To finish off your question. Yeah, to finish up the question, yeah, get friends together, play the game, start doing like dungeons, and just do the MSQ, and don't worry about it.
MSQ
is something, like that. You want to really learn your class and your job first, you know? Yeah. That's why it starts you off really low, and you start learning over time. And then you'll get to that point where you think about it.
So just
get your friend.
I'll show you in the camera. Right. 3 minutes, right?
Oh, one more answer.
Favorite character?
Porsche Fon.
Thank you.
Is there any plans or even a remote chance that we'll get a wardrobe or appearance collection type for our gladiators in the future?
We'd like to see it, but we're not. That's
something we don't have.
Which can
access is bad.
Yeah, we don't have control, but we'd like to see it.
I want that so bad, but yeah, unfortunately, I cannot give you an answer.
Like we said earlier, you guys are the boys, so you want something?
I'm going to slide in and just like tell them, hey.
If McCoy evolved from cats, half of them are still cats.
Well,
deep question.
Listen, you're stuck with a llama fell. That's bigger issues.
Has anybody in this room trying to be violent? How many times you white?
Oh, yeah.
Every single one.
Two minutes.
So, to give you context, this the new. You might, if you were at the booth, you would have seen a little bit of glimpses of it during that 4.1 trailer. It's pretty much Unending Foils Ultimate above Savage. And to this day, I think no one's.
That's not clear.
There's no clear so far. I think the last group that I remember seeing was there up to what, like Comfort Base Three, maybe.
Yeah.
Entering baseball now. So, keep an eye out because that fight looks insane. I know personally people are pulling it right now. And
Corey, minute 45.
Yeah, minute 45. Go.
Yes.
In terms of
raid
and finals, from ARR to Heaven's Word and now Stormborn, what's your favorite and what do you think of the progression so far?
That's a very long question.
That is a great question.
I'll answer real quick. I Evilise right now. I'm really looking forward to it very much. I like this start so far.
Who's the tactics man up
here? Yeah, who's the tactics man up here?
Just amazing.
Good. But yeah, Evilise Ray, I'm looking forward to it.
That's not my question. I mean, like, between AR, Heaven's Word, and Stone Blood, like...
Alexander.
No.
Actually, I'll tell you what, since we're pushing
the last one,
do you want to ask us some answers about the palace?
It's really great.
We've got a minute.
Yeah.
So I'm a returning player. I leveled up to 60 on Heaven's Ward on a warrior.
Sweet.
And currently I'm leveling up a Thaumaturge. What is the most efficient way to level up a second class?
First of all, play every day. Do your doomy roulettes. Now that there's two beast tribes.
Company missions.
Challenge log.
Max out your first class.
Make sure you don't be like me and like do it on a class that's level 70. Yeah. I've had that heartbreak so many times. But challenge log.
You should have asked me yesterday.
And as
much as I don't usually like recommending it,
we also have Palace of the Dead.
Blacklist them!
Changed to a Lala film.
Oh, that's a long
time.
we are nearly a minute over time. I'd just like to thank everybody for coming. On behalf of everybody here, I'd first like to say thank you to Getz. He's been working hard. Everybody.
With Ethis and I at the booth. So if you want to come hang out, we'll ask questions. I'll try and steal this one where I can, And you guys are still able, because there was an amazing question, which I think we should address, but we haven't got time, so we'll address it at the booth. So come on down, hang out, we'll ask you questions there. We'll see you all there. Thank you.